I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. Good morning. Welcome to a short biblical reflection on the Gospel according to John chapter 10, verses 1 up to 18. In the lectionary, the reading starts only from verse 11 because it starts with the phrase, I am the good shepherd. Jesus refers to himself as the shepherd already in verse 2. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. Later he refers himself as the gate. I am the gate for the sheep. And in verse 9, I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved and will come in and go out and find pasture. And now in verses 11 and 14, as the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. I'm the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me. And the image of the good shepherd is set in opposition to those who are called thieves and bandits and the hired hand, which this is the expression which literally means a person hired for a salary. The hired person, which is pictured in verses 12-13, which abandons the sheep when the difficulty trouble comes, is therefore much linked to a thief and bandits, because such person looks only for own benefits. In verse 1 we read, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate but climbs in by another way is a thief and a bandit. And in verse 8, and all who came before me are thieves and bandits. In verse 10, the thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. The image of the good shepherd set in opposition to the hired person, which is identified with thieves and robbers, could recall in particular the prophecy from the book of Ezekiel in chapter 34, where we read, Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel, prophesy, and say to them, to the shepherds, thus says the Lord, woe to you shepherds of Israel who have been feeding yourselves. Should not shepherds feed the sheep? You eat the fat, you clothe yourself with the wool, you slaughter the fatling, but you do not feed the sheep. You have not strengthened the weak, you have not healed the sick, you have not bound the injured, you have not brought back the strayed, you have not sought the lost, but with the force and harshness you have ruled them. So when they were scattered because there was no shepherd, and scattered, they became food for all the wild animals. I shorten the text, and now I resume in verse 10. Thus says the Lord, I am against the shepherds, and I will deny my sheep at their hand and put a stop to their feeding the sheep. No longer shall the shepherds feed themselves. I will rescue my sheep from their mouth, so they may not be food for them. And from verse 11 starts the description of the good shepherd. I myself, I will search for my sheep and I will seek them out. As the shepherds seek out their flock when they are among the scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I skip a few verses and I resume in verse 15. I myself, I will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lay down, says the Lord. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed, and I will bind up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. So we could see how the prophecy in Ezekiah fits well to our passage in the Gospel according to John, and the detailed description of the bad shepherds of Israel recalls the statement of Jesus in our Gospel that all who came before me are thieves and bandits. Now I would like to focus also on the verb to know, which expresses the relation between Jesus the Good Shepherd and his sheep, as well also between him and the Father, as we read in verses 14 and 15. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And the mutual knowledge expressing the relation between the shepherd and the sheep is already expressed in verses 3 and 4. The sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. He goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. And I would say here, even if we translate the Gospel from Greek, but behind there will be also Hebrew concept of the verb yada, which generally means to know, but that knowledge is used in wider sense, because quite often also it expresses personal intimate relations between the people. In fact, even as a marital relation, because for example, when we read in the book of Genesis that Adam knew Eve, it means that they had a relation and then was born a son. And such deep instinct relation between the shepherd and the sheep, we can see also reflected in the statement of St. Paul, firstly in the letter to Romans. Rejoice with those who rejoice, weep with those who weep, live in harmony with one another, do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly, do not claim to be wiser than you are. And then in the letter to Corinthians chapter 9, for thou I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the Jews I became as a Jew, in order to win Jews. To those under the law I became as one under the law, thou I myself I am not under the law, so that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law I became as one outside the law, thou I am not free from the God's law, but I am under Christ's law, so that I might win those outside the law. To the weak I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I might share in its blessing. We could see the prophecy of Ezekiah as a background for this gospel passage, and also an application of the image of the Good Shepherd in the expression of St. Paul. Now let's conclude with the words of Psalm 23. I just read the first lines, you can continue yourself. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lay down in green pastures, he leads me beside still waters. I wish you a nice day, a nice reflection on this gospel reading, as well also other supporting texts.